If you've chosen DAS storage rather than NAS, as I have, you've likely spent a lot of time searching for appropriate dependable hardware to set up a direct attached storage system. I know that I have. I've spent countless hours researching as well as trying out a number of devices and associated software over a number of years now. Zip wasn't a brand that I was familiar with until they contacted me a few months ago. Yet, as Zip says, they've been in the storage game for over 29 years and trusted by creative professionals around the globe. In this video, I'll take a look at one of their most popular products. Check this out. Hi, Ray here with the Zip Blackbox Pro RAID desktop drive with Thunderbolt 3. Before I begin, let me tell you briefly what I've been using for my DAS system until now. First, in this editing room, my computer is a Mac Studio M1 Ultra. I edit all my videos on the system using its super fast 4 TB internal SSD. That's backed up via Time Machine. And until recently, that resided on an 8 TB partition on an 18 TB drive, with 10 TB dedicated to the archive video assets I use frequently in my videos for B-roll, etc. And the 18 TB drive, both partitions, are backed up to external drives. So, to summarize, my approach has been to clone all these external drives. The Time Machine job has recently been given over to a dedicated 8 TB external drive. And it should be noted, these black box units are perfectly suited for use with Time Machine. This Zip Blackbox Pro RAID replaces that 10 TB partition storing files that I use on a daily basis for creating these videos. Blackbox Pro RAID is formatted for macOS in APFC. It's Time Machine compatible right out of the box, or you can easily reformat for Windows. Also, out of the box, it comes configured as RAID 0. More on that in a moment. If you've seen my other video on my, as I called it, unorthodox backup system, you'll know that I've used RAID for more than a decade, a Promise, Pegasus, 4-bay unit, and I mentioned how RAID is not by itself a backup. Nothing's changed there. It's a caution that should be taken seriously. When it comes to the Zip Blackbox Pro RAID, it supports hardware RAID 0, RAID 1, JBOD, and SPAN. So, it has the flexibility to set it up in RAID 0 for maximum speed, or RAID 1 for redundancy. And RAID 1 is what I've chosen, as one drive mirrors another, essentially a clone. More about other config options in a minute. Before I go on, just a note here on arguments for and against hardware RAID. There are technical videos, and I've watched them, that advocate for software and against hardware RAID. I have absolutely no idea what they're talking about. I mean, they may as well be speaking a foreign language. I'm not an IT expert, and I don't have time to become one. After all, I have camera settings to figure out. It's not that I've never used software RAID. I used it with the aforementioned Promise Pegasus system. But let me say, this Zip system is controlled by Set It and Forget It hardware RAID. And I'm all about simplicity. I've been using a similar approach, but using Carbon Copy Cloner to mirror my backups. But that's another step. Here's the solution that you might say found me, and I'm very glad that it did. A bit more about the Zip BlackBox Pro RAID. These come with up to 48 terabytes of overall storage. The bays require included keys to open them. Mine shipped with Toshiba 20 terabyte MG10 series 7200 RPM SATA 3 3.5 inch internal hard drives. I think it's worthwhile to talk a bit about these hard drives. These are enterprise class hard drives with speeds up to 550 megabytes a second, recommended for, quote, cloud scale storage infrastructure, business critical servers, and storage, which certainly meets and even exceeds my needs. Individually, depending where you buy, the 20 terabyte drives generally sell for around US$360 to $400 each. Now consider that this Thunderbolt 3 40 terabyte unit containing two of those 20 terabyte drives retails for $1,299.95 US. There's also a USB-C 3.2 Gen 2 version if you don't need or you can't use Thunderbolt, so you can save a few dollars. You can access a 15% discount with the code Raymond15 on Thrift's website. As far as the enclosure, the aluminum shell also acts as a heat sink to heat the internal hard drive at its optimal temperature, and that avoids thermal throttling. It's wrapped in a removable protective rubber jacket, and this is just one of the features that makes the BlackBox Pro RAID perfect for location work. The power brick is also nicely protected with the same material. The supplied USB-C cable, well, it's barely 50 centimeters. That's under 20 inches long. That works for this arrangement, but if you need to span a greater distance, well, you'll have to buy a longer cable. Ports include dual Thunderbolt 3, 40 GB, so you can daisy chain up to 5 additional devices through a single cable to your computer. The DisplayPort lets you connect a monitor, and I have to say, this was critical for me since I was running out of Thunderbolt 4 ports on the Mac Studio. I was using a DisplayPort to USB-C adapter for one of my displays, and that cost me $50. So this feature freed up the port that the BlackBox is using now. These are also available with optional ingest hub hard readers with the onboard CFast2 SD-UHS2 hard reader. There's a 10 GB USB-A port to connect SSD storage or charge peripherals. More about those RAID modes. As we've seen, the BlackBox Pro RAID enclosure contains two drives which function as one single volume. It supports four drive modes: RAID 1, mirroring; RAID 0, striping; clear, JBOD, just a bunch of disks; and big, spanning. Each mode has its advantages depending on your use case. Again, RAID 0 is the default shipping mode. In RAID 0 striping mode, the two drives are seen by the computer as one large drive. Reading and writing occurs on both drives simultaneously. That's designed to increase speed performance. The built-in RAID controller splits each piece of data across both of the drives in segments and distributes the I.O. burden. And the downside here is that if one drive fails, data can be damaged on both. RAID 1 mirroring offers data redundancy and real-time backup by writing the same data to the two hard drives at the same time. In the case of a drive failure, data is still available on the remaining drive. So the two drives are seen by your computer as one volume but with half the capacity. So this 40 terabyte unit will be seen as a single 20 terabyte drive. Reading and writing occurs on both drives simultaneously so that each of the drives contains exactly the same data mirroring each other. In clear, JBOD, which stands for just a bunch of disks, both drives are used independently. So you choose which hard drive that you would like to save data on, since each drive will mount individually to your computer. B-spanning combines hard drives into a single logical unit. So unlike striping, spanning writes data to the first physical drive until it reaches full capacity, and then data is written to the second physical drive. RAID 0, JBOD, and spanning options, well, they definitely call for redundancy measures. It's very, very important to note that the following procedure will essentially format the drives. So, if you're changing the configuration after use, well, you'd better save your files on another drive beforehand. The configuration options are illustrated on the back of the unit, so it's just a matter of aligning the pins according to your configuration choice, and confirming by pressing and holding the set button for 4 seconds. And then the drive will eject, and on return, it'll connect in the set RAID mode, in theory at least. When I went back to my Mac, it didn't recognize the black box, so I ended up using this utility to format the drive. So this behavior has since been confirmed as normal by Zwift's engineering team. Whichever configuration you choose, all should include plans for offsite backup. My most valuable assets are also stored on Dropbox and iCloud. As I say, I edit my videos, including 8K footage, on the powerful Mac Studio, but this is a great storage solution for me. Now you might be thinking, okay, if this is advertised as a desktop drive, how noisy is it? It's not silent, but it's not terribly noisy either. I'm not bothered by it, and the rubber jacket helps, I think, to insulate it. Yes, I do shut it down when I'm recording voiceovers here, but that's not different to any other drive here. As mentioned, the Zwift community team and their media partners in New York reached out to me as late last year, and long story short, sent me this 40 terabyte 2x20 terabyte unit to test and review. But this isn't a sponsored video. I just get to see the desktop drive, no other strings attached. Zwift didn't screen the video before it was published. My opinions, as always, are my own. So I'll drop links for info and purchase options in the description. So, I hope you found this video useful. If so, please give it the old thumbs up. And if you're new to my channel, please do consider subscribing. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss new content from me. In the meantime, take care, cheers, we'll see you later.